So I made a baseball pachinko hybrid video game. And when it came time to figure out what sound the ball should make as it bounced around, I knew I had to figure out how to make it play Take Me Out to the Ballgame. It was a super fun challenge. Here's how I did it. To begin, I needed to create a rendition of Take Me Out to the Ballgame. So I fired up Ableton and designed a chime sound that I liked. Then, before exporting the track that I played, I turned the tempo way, way down. This ensured that each note of the melody would ring out on its own without any overlapping notes. And because I used MIDI instruments for this recording, I was able to slow down the tempo without any distortions, as opposed to, say, if I, you know, had recorded a guitar or a piano in audio. Now, I had the chimes in an audio format, but I needed each note to be on its own file. So the next step is a fair bit of grunt work. You have to go in and slice out each individual note and export them into its own file. A tip here, if you're going to go down this route, I recommend using the awesome open source audio tool Audacity to handle the slicing and dicing. In Audacity, you can create a macro to help speed things up. I used macros to trim the silence out of the rough cuts I made of each note, and it saved me a bunch of time. If you're doing batch editing of audio files, definitely look into macros in Audacity. Okay, so now I've got the actual files I want to use, 63 audio files, each containing a single note from Take Me Out to the Ballgame. Next comes the technical implementation. When it comes to technical problems, I like to break the problem down into small components. When we break the problem down into small chunks, we take one complicated problem and turn it into a bunch of easier problems. So break it down. How do we break down this problem? Well, to play Take Me Out to the Ballgame with each bounce of the ball, we'll need to be able to do four things. Number one, detect when the ball collides with other objects. Number two, do something when the ball collides with other objects. Number three, how do we play a sound? And number four, group a bunch of sounds together in a way that lets you play them in a specific order. Another way of looking at it is that by breaking the problem down, you end up with questions that are easier to research. For example, the question, how do I play a sound, is a lot easier to research than the entire, how do I play a song one note at a time as a ball bounces along? To demonstrate, let's attack these four requirements as if we knew nothing about Unity. All right, requirement one, detect when the ball collides with other objects. All right, very quickly here, we learn that in Unity, there's a component called the collider that is used to detect and act upon collisions between one object and another. So right off the bat, we know we're dealing with colliders, and if you're trying to create a similar effect on your end, make sure you have a collider on the object you want to use. Well, that's requirement one sorted. Let's move on to the second requirement. Now we need to figure out how to do something when we record a collision. This search also points us to documentation or tutorials, and that's another thing. There's often more than one way to learn whatever it is you need to learn to accomplish your goal. Whether you want to read documentation or watch video tutorials, the Unity community has got it. Looking through this documentation, we find that we are looking for the onCollisionEnter method. We find that any code that we put inside the onCollisionEnter method will be called anytime we record a collision. All right. Well, that's requirement two done. We're halfway there. Requirement three, how to play a sound. All right, we go back to Google and look up some more answers. And again, we have plenty of options for how to pick up this information. Looking through any of them, we'll learn about the audio source component, and that in order to play a sound, we need to use the audio source component. Okay, now we can see that we need to add each of our notes of the song to its own game object. Finally, this brings us on to the last requirement. We know how to make something happen for every collision, and we know how to play a sound, and we have all of our sound files, but we need to find out how to group objects together in code. There are a number of different ways to do that, but I chose an array. With an array, I'm able to create one object that refers to all of the other objects in Take Me Out to the Ballgame. In this array, each note is stored at a certain index value, that is to say 0, 1, 2, etc. And since this is code that we're talking about, you don't have to hard code a number, you can instead use an integer variable. Alright, now let's put it all together. Since I'm using a collider, I can trigger code to play a ping sound on every collision. Since I am using an array, I can change which sound will play from one collision to the next. And when you put those bits together, you get a system where every collision plays a note from Take Me Out to the Ballgame. Actually, you could play any song this way, you just have to be willing to cut out each of the notes of the melody one by one, put them all on game objects, and put them all in an array. This is how I strung together a bunch of simple behaviors into something complex and interesting. I loved figuring this out. I found it really exciting when it all came together. Well, there you have it. That's how I put together the system to play Take Me Out to the Ballgame. If you found this video useful or interesting, I'd love to hear from you in the comments. And be sure to check out Bad Hop Baseball on Steam. Thanks for watching.